Hey there, everyone. Welcome back to The Loft. Thanks for dropping in. So today we're going to look at two or three famous people that you may have heard of that also have dyspraxia, because we're still in our dyspraxia slash autism series. I know we've talked a lot about dyspraxia and not all that much about autism, but I'm dyspraxic and a lot of my autism is manifested through the dyspraxia. So that's why we've covered that a lot and kind of treating it as a both and kind of thing. So today, like I said, we're going to look at three famous people, three celebrities that have that have dealt with issues coming from dyspraxia. And just so you know, every dyspraxic either finds or they should find some activity or hobby that helps with their motor control and movement coordination. At least one activity or hobby. We always have some processing delay issues, but even that can be minimized by coping. For those who deal with us, just know that we can take a while, and yes, it's exhausting for us too. First up today is a young man who's known for playing a famous wizard. Daniel Radcliffe, Harry Potter himself, lives with dyspraxia. He credits the role that made him famous in part for helping him learn techniques to improve movement and coordination. Because the movies were so action-heavy, Radcliffe needed to learn a lot of stunts. Since these stunts were in a controlled environment and were heavily rehearsed, he was able to train his body how to move. He also credits taking some remedial gymnastics as a child as well. The emotional toll of dyspraxia and the pressures of fame did get to him, though, and he drank heavily during his teens, but he sought help. Daniel says he still struggles with tying his shoes and handwriting, but also gives great advice about it. Do not let it stop you. It has never held me back. And some of the smartest people I know are people who have learning disabilities. The fact that some things are more of a struggle will only make you more determined, harder working, and more imaginative in the solutions you find to problems. He has been open about his dyspraxia since at least 2008.
You're dyspraxic, Harry.
Florence Welch of Florence and the Machine struggled early on in school with dyspraxia, choosing to spend more time climbing trees, oddly enough, or visiting the school library than in the classroom. She often faced discipline issues because she'd randomly start impromptu singing. I like her already. Today, she wears her learning issues, dyspraxia and dyslexia, with a badge of honor. Her creative outlet that is now her career was her way of coping. The fact that I work in a creative industry probably helps. We dyspraxics think in a different way. Her song, Dog Days Are Over, makes up some of the musical backing of this video, this very section where we're talking about her. There's a little bit of that song playing. Cara della Cara Delevingne, the model and actress, is also dyspraxic. I'll be honest, I don't know much about Cara, and she hasn't touched too much on her dyspraxia. But I mean, come on, she models in heels. I'll link an article down below where she shares the advice given her on how to strut down the runway in heels, if anyone's interested. It's interesting advice, but not for young ears. So that's why I'm not actually saying it. As I mentioned last week, participating and serving at my church helped me. So did acting as a child and in high school. Being involved in acting also helped with my autism. See, I actually am going to mention it. It helped with my autism and social perception. I would channel things through, how would this character react? Over time, I've developed my personality as a combo of the hopefully better parts of various people in history, actors, and even fictional characters. Mrs. Woody loves it because she never knows who she's married to at any given moment. It could be, well, it could be Ronald Reagan. I forget sometimes. Or Johnny Carson, especially when I do weird, wild stuff. Jimmy Stewart, which is just crazy. Clarence! William Shatner, Captain Kirk, Professor Harold Hill from Music Man, or hello, I'm Johnny Cash. Yeah, I thought I'd throw a little bit of that in there. Next week, unfortunately, will not be as fun. At least the main Friday video won't. And it may be a longer one. I'm just going to go ahead and warn you. But I've thought and prayed about it, and this is part of my story, and it does need to be shared. We're going to go into the more difficult and darker parts, touching largely on my 7th grade year. As you've seen this week, though, I may do a little fun, do a few fun clips now and then, so we're not totally bummed out for the whole week. Thanks again for stopping in, and I'll see you next time.